That editing shit he doing, bro, he on top of his game. That's different.
And it started off like this.
Migo. Crazy,
yeah.
Been having that shit
on. This one ain't biggest biz, right?
Tripping to the floor, to the door, nigga. You
legendary
in trance.
Legendary,
yeah.
Yeah. Right?
We set the trends.
Yeah.
Trends. Bringing it in. Bringing it in. I'ma have to call my account to make sure the shit came in. It's just me and my gang. Fuck niggas. Wanna do friends. Fuck. What he say? He want smoke? Smoke. We gon' spin. Spin again. I've been trying to get the money, I've been trying to feed my family, cause these niggas down wanna see me win. No, I was thinking about the rolling, but I went and cut the riches, then I went and put my mama in the bins. I get it in.
Get it in a pin, fucking two twins. I thought about the block, but I went and put it in.
And the nigga spinning shit without a pen. I called Jimmy, kick it with the Billy. We already ran up a million.
Organized the whole shit, right?
Yeah, me and my bro.
Take me to this vid. Take me to, first of all, RIP Takeoff.
Yeah,
RIP Takeoff. How was it like beating Takeoff?
Oh man, it was dope, man. He's a very like in the cut dude. He very like stayed to himself. He wasn't he's more of an introvert artist, so but he had very dope energy, you know what I'm saying?
So what they say about him is true, that right? He chill,
don't bother nobody, he just, you know, he be in the cut, do his own thing, and it was
so
how
did you even get that video, like
at the time? Well, when the video came out, you know, I've done a lot of work with Jim Jones and, you know, me and my bro Shula the Don, you know, got the call like, yo, we got to get this video done. So, we did the original one in New York and then,
right.
We did
you shot
remix.
Both, right?
Yeah, we did both.
Damn, that's tough.
So he did after the success of the first one, it was like, yo, that Jones on the radio was playing everywhere. It's like, yo, now we need the remix. So, you know, as come with the remix, now we need a video for the remix. And we got all the Migos going.
And then
be
the remix
that.
Had who? The remix had who on it?
Remix had DJ Khaled, had the Migos, and had Lil Wayne.
Nigga shot
and,
for Wayne.
We went to Miami to get DJ Khaled, Juelz, Jim, and then Cali for Lil Wayne and the Migos part.
Damn, I didn't even realize that
and
y'all
New York.
Went to different.
Yeah, it was all over the place. It was all over the place. Went from New York to Miami to LA for those videos.
And y'all shot that in how many days?
It took probably 3 days.
Okay.
3 days. It was two videos. The first video probably I think took us 2 days. And the second one took us like 3 days to shoot the second video.
And if I'm not mistaken, you also shot for Ice Spice.
Yeah, I did
very early on, right?
Yeah, I did a video for her called Euphoric, which
right
out of all her records now, I don't think like when she sent me the record, I wasn't expecting that record. I was very passionate about shooting that record because it wasn't. She was very like lyrical on this.
Yeah, she was
so
talking
like,
on that.
Oh, this is. But she just wanted to. She like, yo, I just want to do something simple so people could just hear the music. So she DM'd me.
Oh, so she reached out to you.
Yeah, she reached out to me, and I was like, you know, I never heard of her. So.
Right, that was very
but
early
I looked
on
her Instagram. She was only doing music for a couple months. She was doing music for probably like 4 to 5 months.
Mm.
And I was like, all right, bet. Let's do it. I work with a lot of female artists. So, you know,
and
a lot
this
of female.
Was this paid?
Yeah, it was paid.
Okay,
she
okay.
paid me out of pocket.
Okay, cool. Yeah.
So like I said, like most of my clients, when they hit me, they already, you know, they expect like, yo, you know, I like your work. I'm gonna pay for the quality. You know what I'm saying? That type of thing.
Would you be open to working with her again or?
Yeah. If she wants to work again, I'll definitely be open for that. Afterwards, she started shifting her direction a little bit. So.
Right. She started going like more drill, you know, pop drill
yeah,
type.
Yeah. She was finding herself. She just came out. So she was finding like her thing. But like I said, like that song she sent me, I was like, yo, this is crazy. Like. Sampled the way she
and that's falling. One of her best songs to this day.
To me, I don't know if you heard the song.
Yeah,
like,
I heard
her
it,
catalog.
Yep.
But to me personally, I'm not even being biased because I shot the video. But to me, that's like one of her. Like she really was going off when she writes her stuff. We was in the studio. She was just her engineer.
Okay.
Riot.
She wrote that song with you in there.
No. She was just going through it. Like her and her producer Riot. They have a very like very dope chemistry in the studio. And No Jumper came to the studio that day that we shot that video to interview her too.
So, bye. Bye. Okay.